An idea that changes society often begins at the fringes of it. The minds responsible for those ideas often too come from the underappreciated, the underprivileged and the persecuted. Let's start with Leonardo da Vinci, the original Jon Snow, an illegitimate son. His poor social status meant an even poorer education, but not a poor appetite for learning. He became an artist's apprentice and read fanatically. As an adult, da Vinci excelled in pretty much every field, from anatomy to architecture, music to mathematics, with ideas so advanced for his time that many of his inventions couldn't be produced until centuries later, like the armored tank, machine guns, and the helicopter. The father of modern science, Galileo Galilei, improved the telescope and advocated the now generally accepted notion that the Earth revolves around the Sun and not the other way around. For his beliefs, he was shunned. He defended his discoveries and was found to be guilty of heresy by the church. To avoid getting burnt at the stake, Galileo recanted his findings but was put under house arrest for the last 7 years of his life. Nikola Tesla, the often forgotten man of electricity, developed the modern alternating current, which powers every home on the planet. The Serbian engineer moved to America to work for Thomas Edison in 1884, and later became his rival in the War of the Currents. Edison firmly planted on direct current and Tesla alternating. AC reigns supreme, and it is still the most economical means for transmitting electricity. Tesla wanted to provide free energy to the world, but his best attempt at this was shut down due to a lack of funding. He held hundreds of patents for his inventions, but died bankrupt after a few expensive failed electrical projects later in life. And from electrical energy to atomic power. Marie Curie discovered polonium, radium, and became the first woman to win a Nobel Prize. An outsider, simply because of her gender, she had to go to the Sorbonne because Warsaw University didn't admit women. Marie was a foreigner in France and from not quite the right social class in Poland, and it was her own discoveries that led to her demise, dying in 1934 from aplastic anemia from long-term exposure to radiation. To this day, her papers are kept in lead-lined boxes, and those who wish to consult them must wear protective clothing. Whether held back by social status, gender, or ideas too controversial, the outsiders of science and invention managed to change and enlighten our lives for the better, even if some of them didn't get the recognition they deserved in their own lifetime.